Paul Sikora. I'm the president and CEO of Pollyanna Brewing.
My name is Sheila Callahan. I'm the tap room manager here at Pollyanna Brewing Company.
I'd love to show you around. Thank you guys for coming. Wanted to hatch a plan to possibly look at doing something different, kind of in my second half of life. I worked for a Fortune 500 electrical distributor called Graybar. I was looking to reduce my commute a little bit and have a little bit of fun.
I worked a boring office job. I was sick of it. And I heard they were opening, and they hired me on as a server. And it was a lot of fun, and I grew with the company. They promoted me to taproom manager. So it was really cool to be here from the beginning, and now I get to be the keeper of the beer.
We wanted a production brewery. We thought we wanted a taproom, and we wanted to work through just distribution to get our product out in the marketplace throughout Chicago. I'm so glad we went with Pollyanna. My first choice was Lamont Brewing Company, and I'm so glad we didn't go with that. Brian, our brewmaster, had a blog going when he was at brewing school called Pollyanna. And Pollyanna is a noun meaning irrepressibly optimistic. So he really looked at things as the glass being half full, always looking on the bright side. We adopted the name Pollyanna, voted on the name, and it's been a great name. It certainly gets the question, what is Pollyanna, all the time? And we certainly go with the overall concept of the name Pollyanna and being irrepressibly optimistic. And of course, one of our taglines is crafted optimism. When we opened up, we had 6 30-barrel fermenters and a 15-barrel brew house, and with those 30-barrel fermenters equate to about 930 gallons of beer, which will end up being in each one of those fermenters. If we're gonna fill that up, we have to brew twice, so 15 barrels times 2 is 30, so that's how we typically would brew back-to-back. We have one 30-barrel bright tank, which is kind of that bottleneck in the entire brewery. All the beer has to go through the bright tank. We got everything into this building kind of through the downstairs double doors. It was kind of an engineering marvel to get everything into here. But, you know, we got it to work, and everything's been up and running. With the expansion of 5 more 30-barrel fermenters and 1 more 30-barrel bright, we could do up to 6,000 barrels now per year. So the demand's been out there. Craft beer has certainly been booming, and we're able to afford getting the equipment and to bring it in and do it all at once. And we started putting beer in fermenter number 7. We've got 4 flagships, and we started off the brewery with having these 4. One is called the Full Lamonti, kind of a play on words there from the Full Monty and the Village of Lamont. A lot of people like to call it the Full Lemony, but it's all about Lamont. It's a 5% golden ale, very easy drinking, crisp, very light. I mean, if anybody were to say what's your lightest beer, which most people do, it's typically the Full Lamonti. Out of the tap room, probably the most popular. It's a gateway beer that kind of gets people into craft for tasting for the first time. So people enjoy that. Our next beer is Maisie, which is a pale ale. It's a 5.4% ABV beer. It's got some nice hops in it. It's got a touch of wheat, so it's got a little bit of sweetness to it, and it's very well balanced. One of the things I always like to talk about with Pollyanna is Brian's competency with balancing out the beers and making beer consistently. Probably one of the most important things with that is we want to have our flagships taste like our flagships today, tomorrow, and the next day. So in order to do that, you really have to be good at what you're doing and be able to promote and to have consistent beer coming out of those tanks at all times. Our next flagship is Lexical Gap. That's our IPA. It's a West Coast style. It has some really great West Coast hops. Your Centennial and your Citras and your Simcoes, kind of a nice grapefruit taste to it. Certainly well balanced. Most people will say it's one of the best IPAs they've ever had. At GABF last year, it was in the top 10 in the country. Our last flagship is Eleanor. Eleanor is a porter. Eleanor Porter was the author of Pollyanna, a book that was written in 1913. So that was kind of a slam dunk when it came to naming that beer. Our porter is a robust porter. It's with English malts. It has a nice coffee note, a little bit of chocolate. I would say maybe a little bit of raisin, prune. Certainly, as it warms up, tastes even better. It's one of the beers that our brewmaster likes to brew the most. He thinks it's his, he kind of calls it his baby. And it's one of that, I think, as far as our beers go, he likes to mess around with that a little bit. So he's done some adjuncts to it. We've done with coffee in it. We've done it barrel-aged. We've done it with vanilla. We've done it with tart cherries. So different variants of the same base beer. And when we do that, people seem to really look for it then. We also put Eleanor on nitro, which makes it even more desired in the marketplace because people then are really looking for a nice special from us. Our first seasonal that we had that was a really big commercial success was Summerly, and that is a raspberry wheat beer. We also have Hefeweizen called Hump and Scrump. Hump and Scrump is a musical instrument, of course, related to the hurdy-gurdy.
My personal favorite right now is actually the Hefeweizen Hump and Scrump. It's a really nice, clean German-style beer, wheat, and it's got the clove and banana that comes along with Hefeweizen.
We decided if we were going to support somebody on the side of having a guest tap, we want to do something we didn't have, and gluten-free, which was another option. So we decided to go with Right Beside Her, and they've been a great partner for us. People really enjoy the gluten-free option. So we started out of the gate with our distributor. We were able to self-distribute, and we also went with a distributor. So we have a pretty good street name, Pollyanna does, out in the city. We've got some great locations in the city, but we also have some great locations out in the burbs. And a couple of those are Ditka's, as well as probably our biggest customer right now is White Sox Park. They've took on our Full Amonte on draft, and we also have our Lexical Gap cans there too. We also changed our license to a brew pub.
We do beer really well, but we like to bring other people in that do food really well. So on weekends, we try and have food trucks or our catering in-house.
We really wanted to be able to have events, and that license allowed us to have off-site and off-premise type of events now.
We do a lot of different events. One of our more popular is Oktoberfest. We hold that in September. We also do a really good anniversary party. And then we do smaller bottle releases as well. When we do one-offs or barrel-aged beers, people get their bottles and enjoy the rest of their day.
I think from the very beginning, we always knew that the tap room mezzanine area was going to be really cool to look down onto the brewery. And we wanted to have a space that basically we wanted to go to. That was really when we saw this facility, why we went with it. Our vision for it, there were certain things that were here that we thought we had great amount of light coming in the brewery. You had a bird's eye view of fermenters and the brewing process. We always figured people would like to come in during the day when Brian is brewing and take a look at the facility and actually see what he's doing. It's not like it's on the other side of a wall. It's right here and you get to see the whole thing. I mean, you can feel the humidity when you walk in, you can smell the smells. You're right here, part of the process. And that's something that we really enjoyed, being able to give our customers. And of course then, when we're shut down on the weekends and when we're not brewing, I mean, it's just kind of a fun place.
It's a very nice, relaxing, and family kind of oriented place. We do allow children in our tap room, and Sundays are family days, and it's nice to see families coming together enjoying craft beer.
We love to bring people in, educate about craft, do tastings, do tours, and do private events here.
We've got the outdoor seating area for kids to run around and also chalkboard downstairs.
We love the space, we love the outdoor seating, and it really is unique here in Chicago.
Lamont is on a canal here, the I&M Canal. It's a very nice, hilly community.
Lamont has been around for a long time, since the 1800s. Lamont is, popularity-wise, was the I&M Canal, which of course went from Lake Michigan to the Mississippi. That's how goods got brought down to New Orleans and to the Gulf.
Lamont itself has got the most beers and churches, I think, ratio-wise. The bars down here are unique, and when we came in, I think it offered a very cool addition to Lamont.
And they continually support us. They like to have events here, and certainly having a brewery in town is nice for the rest of the community. It's a kind of a meeting place for a lot of people. We're all college graduates. We're all pretty intelligent guys. But, you know, at the end of the day, you still have to kind of roll the dice on it, having everything happen. And, you know, when it does come together, you feel pretty proud. And that's one of those things we like to portray, is that we're really proud of the space and what we've become. Thank you guys for coming. Please swing by sometime for a pint at Pollyanna. We've got great outdoor seating along the beautiful I&M Canal. Thanks.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching. If you like what you saw, you can click down below where there's some more episodes for you to watch. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe on episodes that you do watch. We hope to see you next time.